welcome to your favorite Tennessee Titans podcast, Tennessee Titans Weekly. Jacques, what's up, y'all? We are here at the game, post-gaming it up, Jacques. Hey, man, as you see, there's 2 minutes left to go in the game.
Keep going, keep talking.
And so, I'm going to tell y'all, man, like, a lot of good things, but there's a lot of concerns, too. I mean, right now, we're winning, but... So, Jacques, talk to which. I'll say this one thing. I got some concerns in certain positions, man. Jacques, you hit them off first, man. What you think?
So you want me to go first?
You go first with it, man.
So, I'm concerned about our offensive line, the depth behind our offensive line. Dylan Raiders, man, he's trending down, bro. Like, dude is not the best. I'm sorry. You got receivers, and you can contract me if I'm wrong.
Absolutely.
They look like they locked up out there.
They are. They're locked up.
Now, we at the games, and of course, you've been hearing different things from the different media saying different things. But I feel like they're getting locked up, and it's not giving the quarterbacks time to really just get it out there. Another thing is Treylon Burks. Where you at, bro?
Where you at, Treylon?
You know what I mean? Where you at? Defensively, Caleb Farley, he's fighting for his job.
He is.
Okay, he's fighting for his job. Roger McQuarrie was in there making plays.
Yep.
Caleb still looked like he's trying to put it together. So don't be surprised if you see Roger McQuarrie out there on day one starting.
Yes, sir.
Cal Phillips is the truth. He's the real deal.
He is.
Let me see. What else? Defensive line, Rashad Weaver. My guy.
Absolutely.
Rashad Weaver.
Yeah,
it's the truth. This is going to be his breakout season.
Yep.
That's what my observation. What about you?
So a lot of people I was sitting at kept saying, Malik, throw the ball. Throughout the entire field, I could see the whole field, receivers were getting locked up. And it's kind of like, well, who's he going to throw it to? The ref, right, or to the defense? And a lot of his throwaways were smart plays if you saw it here on the field, right? So I was not impressed with the wide receivers. And, you know, they're going to have to step it up. Treylon Burks is going to be on the field as a starter. He's going to have to really play well. And, you know, overall, you know, when I look at the backups, we don't have a lot of depth at receiver either. Like, you know, some of the backups is out there. Robinson played pretty well, right, when his number was called. But, you know, basically, Kinsey wasn't really nowhere to be if I had a drop. You know, you look at, you know, the receiver group is going to really step up. And I've been kind of discouraged and actually disappointed in our receivers right now. I will say as well on defense, you point out the offensive line, which I do agree on offense. On defense overall, I was pretty impressed with the defense today. I will tell you, and I do have some concerns with our corners. Our starters, our backup corners, there's several plays on here that got beat. And Trask just didn't see them, or the receiver just didn't catch the football. So those are some concerns that I'd say. But, you know, we can highlight the strengths too, right?
Right. And that's the thing. That's what I don't want to do is just keep harping on weaknesses.
Yep.
Good thing today, and Malik's not going to play this season, but from what I wanted to see from preseason one to preseason two, is impressive as hell.
Yes.
Okay? He's developing in front of our eyes, right?
Yep.
And he took like a couple of plays for him to settle down, but he's making plays where he's getting it. I was excited to see him out there.
Yes.
When Logan Woodside goes out there, I'm like, okay, the game sucks. I'm done, right? I'm cutting it off.
Yeah.
Dude is a highlight reel, all right?
Yep.
Some things he still has to clean. There's a lot of things he still got to clean up.
Facts.
But what I think I like, he's very smart.
Yep.
He doesn't make the same mistake twice. He knows when to run. He knows when off script. Throwing sidearm. He did it the sidearm thing again.
Yep.
Today, Patrick Mahomes did the same thing, right?
Yep.
So we're seeing a star develop in front of our eyes, and people got to be patient to let it simmer. Because I know a lot of people, we was doing the same thing. Let it go. So you see what I'm saying? So the thing is, receiver wise, Robert Woods is not out there. Austin Hooper's not out there. Treylon is open on some plays, but it seems like Logan Woodside doesn't trust him. Malik is not throwing to him. We'll see him when the season starts, when Ryan Tannehill gets, because Ryan Tannehill got chemistry.
Facts, no paper.
So I believe when we see that, I think we will be okay.
Yep.
It's just, if the coaching staff still believes Logan Woodside is the second quarterback, you can kiss my, you know what, right? Because dude, he's thrown three interceptions throughout this whole preseason, okay?
Yep.
And I'm looking at, now I'm going to go back to what you said about cornerback. Even though I have some issues, I do like what they brought in to the additions. The Johnson Jr. guy, he made a couple of plays. Shakir Brown, I believe that's his name, Shakir or something like that. He's had some good PBUs.
Yeah.
So even though we have concerns, we also there's some upside, but you just better hope your starters don't get hurt.
That's right.
Right?
That's right.
I'm trying to think what else. Running backs running pretty hard, man. Haskins and Chestnut.
Yep.
The problem is your O-line is so freaking trash that you really can't see how it's developed. But I know the first series they had, Taylor Lewan out there, correct me if I'm wrong, Brewer?
I think, yeah, Brewer, yes.
They have Brewer out there. So that tells me that they want to see what Malik can do behind a good offensive line.
Facts.
Now, another thing on that play, that touchdown throw that he threw to Chig, was perfect. He went through his progressions.
It was.
1, 2, 3, he led Chig open. He threw that. He threw a dart.
He did.
And it hit his face mask, okay?
Yep.
But he still caught it. So I would like to see Malik kind of take it off the touch and stop. Now, another point I bring up, that long pass to Traylon Burks that
Logan was
Malik probably would have put a lot more air into that, and it would have gave Traylon a better chance.
Right.
This third preseason game, I want to see Tannehill play, and I want to see him get to these receivers like that.
Right.
But who are you impressed with tonight, huh?
I was very impressed with two players in particular. Joe Jones on the defense, right? 42, the linebacker. He had a sack, he had three tackles, and he had an interception. Joe Jones played a great game of defense, and then on his return, he ran like he was Derrick Henry out there. So I was very impressed with how he played. But I've been very impressed with Malik Willis tonight. Malik Willis, he stepped up, he played well. He had almost 50 yards rushing, throwing the ball pretty well, especially as the game kept going on, getting a feel for it, and making things happen. His elusiveness is unbelievable. And seeing it live, you know, most quarterbacks would have been sacked 90% of the time, but the way that he plays smooth and in control. So again, we're looking at a rookie who played very composed tonight, and he's getting better. He's better than what he did last week, and that's all you can ask for a rookie. And so we talk so much about Malik Willis, and what I'm saying is we got other players. Malik Willis ain't gonna play this year, but the opportunities he's gotten today, he did a really good job today overall, so I was very impressed with him. I was impressed with Haskins, the running back, and also Chestnut. I felt they ran the ball very well with the opportunities they had. I don't know how many yards they had rushing, but I think overall, with the lack of offensive line blocking, I felt that they did a really good job. Defense, Rashawn Weaver played great tonight, man. He's gonna be on the field. He, you know, he's not gonna start because you got Bud Dupree and you got Harold Landry, but he will find a spot for sure. So he did really great. Well, he did real well today. And I was really impressed with Kyle Phillips in returning the football. Caught it securely, made plays, made moves. I think they got something in this guy, man. So there was a lot of positives within this for sure. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I just think moving forward to be a playoff team, these guys that are playing today in this preseason game, a lot of them are going to be on the field. They got to step it up for sure. For sure.
Yeah, definitely. And me, like you said, Kyle Phillips really impressed me. Malik continues to make plays and make things happen when the play breaks down. He's an off-script guy. That's where he's been living.
Yep.
Now he needs to live, and when you have a clean pocket like he did right there, he'll keep getting better. Haskins, I'm impressed with Haskins. Haskins is pretty dope too. Let me see. Dez Fitzpatrick, what, caught two passes?
He caught two passes.
Two passes. I like that.
Yep.
We just got to get Traylon involved. Chig is as advertised,
yep.
Right?
Yep.
It's just with this team, you just got to put it together. But defensively, that. I'm impressed with Roger McQuarrie.
Me too,
and
man.
And Theo Jackson.
Yeah, me they because they battle. Caleb Farley was hit or miss today.
Yeah, yeah. Caleb Farley, he's gonna have to really battle it out to get that position.
Yeah, he is. And they was picking on him.
Yes, oh yeah.
They was picking on Caleb.
Oh yeah.
Yep.
Any final thoughts?
Man, my final thoughts is, you know, again, Tennessee with the win, 13-3. My thoughts today is Tampa. Trask is not good. He's not that good. And so when you have a quarterback like that on the field, defensively, I think we took advantage of that. And so I'm proud of how the defense played, the young guys. I think I was more impressed with the defense than the offense. I'd say those guys that on defense that will get to play, I think they learned a lot today on their reps. Again, Malik Willis, don't buy in the conception of he needs to throw. What we saw today, receivers were not getting open. I'll be the first one to say if he needs to throw the ball. We said that when we drafted him, that at times we see like he should go ahead and make that decision. But today, seeing it live, I understand why he didn't throw the ball. And the times he did when no one was open, he threw it away. That's smart. And when he ran when he needed to, and he made hella plays. So my final thought is, I'm proud of Malik Willis, how he played. I'm proud of how our defense played. I'm proud of how Kyle Phillips played. Other guys are going to have to really step it up. Guys that's going to be on the field, they're going to have to step it up, man. What about you, Jock?
Like I said, I'm impressed with our defense. Our defense is as advertised. Like, I'm not worried about our defense, to be honest with you, especially with the D-line and what they did today. They created pressure. They got sacks. They got turnovers. The defense did their thing. I have no worries. Mine is the cornerback position, but I still think they'll be okay because of the pressure. We got good depth on the defensive line, too, so that's what you need. Yeah. Like you said, with Malik, we're seeing it live. Receivers are really not getting open. And it's preseason. They're not scheming. They're not making up pre-plays. It's cookie cutter. So you making something out of nothing. He will get one day a chance to scheme and look at things and do things. Some things he could be tied down in play calling, right? One thing I did respect, he tried to give an opportunity to Traylon throwing it downfield.
Right.
He tried to give an opportunity to certain receivers that just didn't catch the ball, right? Vrabel's motto is, if the ball hits your hand, you catch it, right? So, offensive line, we need to get depth fast, right?
Fast.
Somebody needs to step
facts,
up.
Facts, no paper.
Somebody needs to step up, or and Dylan Raiders is trending down. Dylan had a couple of bad penalties. I think it might be two or three.
Yeah.
Had a holding call. I don't know what's wrong with this kid, and this is what happens when you pull from small schools. You see what I'm saying? He's a good run blocker, but pass blocker, he's not the best.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, Nicholas Petit Ferreira started over him. That tells you something, right?
That's right.
That young man just needs reps, and he just needs it. Luckily, you're playing the Giants the first game, so it's not a real big challenge, but then you got the Bills the next game, right?
That's right.
And after that, I think you got the Raiders. So you're going to run into some hiccups, but next week, I want to see Tannehill out here.
Yeah, me too.
I want to see what, because they've been bragging about him in training camp and everything.
Yep.
Let's see if he's shucking the rust off. Let's see if he's not throwing these interceptions, because if that starts to happen, you see what Malik is doing. He's creating highlight reels. This second week, he done had a highlight reel.
Yep.
He didn't run for a touchdown. He threw for a touchdown. Everybody's telling him, stay in the pocket. He stayed in the pocket, right?
Yep.
He did what he did. So everybody's complaining, well, he's not doing this. He's a rookie, one. Two, give him time to develop. And three, he's not playing this year. So just whatever, right?
Yep.
So that's
yep.
my final thoughts, bro.
Cool, man. Cool. Well, hey, as we always say again, we appreciate y'all checking our show as well. And as we always say, man,
facts! No paper!
Yes, sir!